Alrighty, viewers, we made it back down to where we were before. Just save the game if you're wondering. So, anyway, there's a healing thing here too. Wish I wanted to use that healing potion. Damn it. Anyway, let's just go. So this isn't even where the boss is, like I thought. So I've been fighting a lot of these guys, and well, for another thing, killer swords. And I actually almost got killed by a killer sword once again. So I was kind of pissed. I was like, come on, really? You get 1,000 experience a pop for those guys, so they're worth killing every time you see them. Well, not the killer swords, but those guys. So. Okay. I forgot that, putting some points into one of the extra things does help, because it'll give you more points towards the one thing. That potion may not actually be a bad idea to just go ahead and equip. If you may have noticed, I also equipped the med kit, which I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad idea right now. Because it's supposed to activate the second your health hits zero. And I don't know if I should, like... You know what? Actually, I will take it off. Because something tells me I'm going to regret it later. Actually, no. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Here's some... We got some new moves. We got Aqua Tornado now. Burst Flare. Chant Wind. Which we've had before. But, you know, just some, you know, interesting things that we've had. Very cool. Use that whenever you get a chance, right? Is it something I can escape from? Yeah, let's do it. Ah, this summer creature looks really tough. Let's try our best. So, this is the enemy that it was talking about. It's some kind of like machine enemy. Before you go up to it, switch to that. Let me make sure of something real quick. Yeah, that's all it does is defense 5. Okay. I can't believe I didn't have that on. I seriously thought I did. And that's why I was like so surprised that all these enemies are doing shit tons of damage to us. But that should definitely help us. Here we go. Heavy metal. Now, you can attack it. Just know that doing so... will cause your weapon to kind of obliterate real fast. Especially if you're using a spear. So... basically what I'm saying is don't use a spear against it. If you're wondering what I used against it, I actually used a sword against it the first time I fought it. Of course, if you do that, just know that it will probably destroy your sword. Let's see how much damage it took. So what are you supposed to do then, if you're wondering? Well, this. Any elemental magic will work against him. Maybe not that well, but it works enough that it's better than trying to use your, weapon and destroying it. Any of his attacks can be blocked, so don't try. See, I almost have him. And near the end, just attack him with your weapon. Ha 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 ha! I love that victory pose. Learn weapon shield. Oh yeah, that's very useful if you're trying to use, like, you know, trying to get everybody's weapon in the game. That can be very useful. Ah, it's a dragon fang ore. Yeah, let's take it to the old man. Wait a sec, is that something creature protecting this? Now, you could keep going. And I don't really know if there's anything special. Yeah, if you try, he just does that. But realize that you're gonna be in danger of dying the whole way. So only fight battles that you know you can win. Like, so if you find a killer, like, you know, spell armor or whatever, don't fight it. Let's put some points into attack, why not? Alright, so let me check something. Just so I make sure I get the name right. Yeah, it's called Killer Sword, that's right. So, as you can see here, that's what its stats are. It has 900 HP most of the time. I think it can get more than that. It has 500 attack, 66 defense, and 20 agility. That's why it's so hard to kill. But then you got the Spell Lance and Spell Axe. Those things are nothing. Oh, it's a level 20. That's another thing that helps out a lot, I'm sure. You know, a lot of these bestiary things that you're going to fill in here, you won't fill in until a lot later. So don't worry if you're like, I'm missing a bunch of them. Don't worry. It takes you a long time to find them. So what happens if I do this? Oh! So it'll tell you even more about them. Cool. Which, obviously, if you go down to the spell armors and shit, it's just gonna tell you, oh, Mystic Ore, yep. Yep to do, you know? So, yeah. I think it also told you how much experience you get. I didn't know it did that. Oh, now I'm only getting 800 from them. Like I said, as your, level increases, it does seem like you get less experience from them. That's why I think it's funny that it tells you, oh yeah, you'll get this much experience from them. I'm like, really? If you do want to make yourself, your life easier, you can use an amulet at this time. We're only up to 8 minutes. Okay, I'm back. I'm sorry about that. I just really wanted to cut out that fight and get closer to where we need to be. So let's go, shall we? By the way, there is a certain thing I wanted to show to you guys. So, look at our status here with our weapons, right? I'm just getting comfortable with that if you're wondering why you're hearing all that noise. As you see, each weapon has an attack stat, defense stat, agility, and durability, right? We've known this, right? But there's something I don't think I've ever made references to. You have a technique, thing. The technique, stat, as you can see, like my Zentetsu blade, it's 88 on that, right? Let's go to another weapon. On the Kinnan's axe, it's 120. Now, the funny thing is, here's something that I never knew about this game until now, because like, I've never really paid too much to the techniques. But depending on what the technique is of your weapon, you will do more damage with it. You'll actually do more damage, it'll take less durability when you block and when you attack. And I think with axes you can also move a little bit faster with them too. So here's the thing. So, you know, like, let's see, well, like the Yari, for example, has 53. The other one I have has 55. I think 120 is the highest it goes. So, you notice that with most of my weapons, I don't really have very high, you know, technique, because I rarely use them, because I'm afraid to use them. Especially fists, because you have to get so close to the enemy. So it's like, depending on what the enemy is, I would recommend, if you got a weapon that you just favor overall, use that against it, because you'll have a higher technique on that, and thus you will do better damage to them. But say you're building up weapons, fight someone weaker, like the slime enemies. They still will give you technique, even if you defeat them in one hit. Congratulations, you seem to have defeated the summon creature. Does that mean you knew about that huge summon creature? That I did. But he just wanted to train you his way. And I think I can entrust you with this. What? What will you entrust to me? Come here. This is the Western Sword. Really? Draw the sword. What? Draw it quickly. Do it. Alright. It came out. Now, you must keep this Western Sword, Mike. Wait a minute. No. Word got out that the sword was here and that I found it. So, I rely on you. Huh? But... hey, wait! She's gone. Anyway, let's get out of here and take this to the old man. Now, what's funny about the Western Sword, I don't even think you can equip it. Yeah, see, it's not anywhere in your, equipment. So, where is it? Well, I think it's in, like, one of your key item, like, areas. Yeah, event item. Yeah, see, it's right here. A sword imbued with special powers. This can't be used here. Can't use it anywhere, really. So, yeah, just keep that in mind. It's nice to have, but it kind of sucks because it's like, well, you know, you get it, and that's all well and good, but you can't, for the life of you, use it anywhere. Oh my god, I forgot about that. How high you jump with this. One thing you should notice is the way that I'm jumping all over the frickin' screen like this, that means my agility stat is way higher than it usually is. So you should just keep that in mind. Also, the fist is probably not a good idea to use against a flying creature because, as you can see, it's almost impossible to hit him with it. Damn it. There we go. Anyway, the stairs are up here. It's fun seeing older people get depressed looking at my weapons. Older people get depressed, huh? He's still pretty confident, just as I thought. But I don't think that I've reached your skill level. I'll never lower my guard until I defeat you. Farewell. I think he's overestimating me. I believe you do fight him. I don't remember entirely, but I think you do end up fighting him. Thank you. Treasury 7 were sent to the member to the trespass or sent to the home. Okay, you've heard that before. Anyway, before you do anything, absolutely go and heal up. And break down any materials you got. Which I didn't really get very many, so. Let's see. I would have laughed if it had, like, said, says he doesn't get a whole bunch, has like 600 things in his inventory. I would have laughed so hard. I think I have gotten the I think I have gotten the max amount of items before, and accidentally wasted some by accident by trying to make more, not knowing I was at the max, and I was like, oops. Of course, I have nothing for water, so I can't make any of that stuff. Crap. Well, the arm support I would be able to, but no. I'm thinking about selling that. Speaking of, is there any weapons I can make? Well, I would have been able to had I, oh, right here, I can make this one at least. Wait, that's just a Valeri spear with wind probably on it. Oh, speaking of, this one guy was telling me, like, in his guide, he was like, believe it or not, even though it would technically be a perfectionist 100% to do this, it's impossible to get all your technique in the game on your first playthrough. Because you have to have different, you know, summon creatures, you have to have different, what do you call it? You have to break every opponent's weapon to be able to get it. But he said, like, only certain ones of them, like, are really important if you ever really want to do it. And even then, like, you just get a technique, you know? So, I don't know. I would actually recommend... You know, back when I was trying, you know, when I got Chavez's weapon, or Chavez, I think is how you say his name, and I was like, yeah, it does seem like it's very useful because it kills your agility. They actually say that it's actually recommended that you use it at the beginning of the game. Fun what you learn whenever you do stuff, right? Anyway, we need to go up here. Aha, I stopped myself. Dangerous because it's under construction. He's not here. I wonder where he could be. I just wanted to show that. I think I remember where he is supposed to be. Let's see. Shit, call me in. I just forgot already. No. It's an event item because you can't use it. Yeah, Dragon Fang. Here we go. Yeah, that's okay. You just come into his house like you're supposed to. And then you come out here looking for him. What the? The old man is being attacked. Are they soldiers? Master Sakura? Soldiers from Dugai. What would a militant nation want with the City of Swords? Hey, we know what you have. Quiet down. Master Rondo. Oh, Now I totally butchered his name, I don't care. Sakura! What master would do? He seems to be a higher master than Master Sakura. So, what does that mean? What's all this noise? I have no idea. The only thing I know is that there are some fellows. I want to go back to bed. Is that okay with you? Not a problem. I can't believe it, but perhaps Master Mateo is... Did you not recognize who he is, my buddy? No. He is the headmaster of the craft lords, the idol of all craft knights, and his weapons shine like no other in the universe. He is Master Mateo, the craft lord of diamond. I can't believe that you didn't realize it. But I've never had a chance to see him up close. Hey you, don't ignore us. Listen, old man, give us your sword now. I don't know what you're talking about. If you want to pick a fight, that boy and his friend will take up your challenge.
What? Wait up!
Huh, is this kid gonna fight us? Come on. Yes, I'll take you on. Come on.
Oh no, what am I saying? The words just slipped out of my mouth.
We'll show you the fighting skills of Dagata soldiers. Might as well take this guy on. Go ahead and use Go All Out. Don't even bother trying to break this guy's weapon. It's basically your sword, so... Like the Zentetsu blade that you have, so... Breaking it... is not at all required. I keep doing that move wrong. If you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm trying to uppercut him. I'll regret it if I don't. You know what, this is a good way to build up my weapon, so might as well. Master Mateo and I got rid of them. Good job, my money. That was quite a performance. Oh, thanks. They're really strong and tough. Despite all this fighting, they haven't broken a sweat. Ah, I must have forgot Cutie, of course. Thank you. This friendly old man is the head of craft lords. He ranks way above his craft knights. Yet, he's just a friendly old man when he talks to me. Oh, I brought the ore that you asked me to get you. Oh, thank you very much. Delivered Dragon Fang ore. Wait, where did you get that sword? A woman gave it to me. A woman? Ah, I got it. Master Mateo, it must be... Yes, it must have some connection. You better ask Braun about that sword and get his advice. It must be an important item, so watch out. Do not lose sight of it. Yes, sir. By the way, Sakura, you came here to tell me something, didn't you? Yes, we lost contact with our investigators 5 days ago. Is that right? My retirement seems to be over now. I was really enjoying it. But you must return to work as a craft lord. Master Mateo looks very reluctant. My money, I'm afraid I can't tell you about Shintetsu anymore today. I believe we'll have another chance to talk about him later on. Please say hello to Maris and Braun. Yes, sir. It's too bad, but I understand. As for the tournament, I have faith that you'll have a fine showing and become a craft lord. Good luck. Oh, yes, thank you. Yeah, we'll see.
My money!
Hey, what's going on? Huh? Is the fighting over already? Aww. Master, what were you expecting? Oh, I just thought I could beat some bastards up to work off some stress. Master, you know what? My mom hates violence. Well, I wanted to stop them. I wasn't doing it because I liked it. Honest. Anyway, my money, what's that sword? A woman gave it to me. Master Mateo said that I'd better ask you for some advice. Hey, Cutie, that's...
I'll keep the sword here with me.
What? Why?
Is that okay, bro?
Oh, yeah, sure, no problem. Please go right ahead.
Are you sure, Master?
I already said yes. Why don't you give that sword to Maris now?
Yes, sir. What's wrong?
Nothing.
I just remember the old times. It's been 3 years already.
Some food for you.
Have dinner with me today and then go back to your workshop.
Wow, thanks!
You want to eat as well, Master?
No thanks. I'm gonna make myself scarce today.
Relax and enjoy yourself. It'll be a family gathering that was a long time coming.
Oh, alright.
He's acting differently than usual. What night would this be? That was a very good meal. Did you like it, cutie? I'm so full. Today was a busy day. Master Rendeo, despite being the highest ranked craft lord, is a very friendly person. Western will be okay as long as he's staying here. He was Dad's friend, so does that mean he's my master's friend as well? That's a bit hard to imagine.
Okay, I'm gonna ask someone.
Okay, so, you know, we've been talking to practically everybody, and, you know, I've talked to Razzie, I think I've talked to Razzie a few times and stuff. Here's the thing, this is technically a spoiler, so if you hate those, you might want to skip ahead a little bit, or, you know, mute, but basically, here it goes. The person you choose now, or before, I'm not sure which one exactly, determines your, like, who you end up with, like, not end up with, but, like, who you see at the end of the game. So, just keep that in mind. I've had a very difficult time deciding who to choose, though. Okay, anybody else who muted their mic or anything like that, we're back. So, yeah, I honestly don't know who to choose. You know what? What the hell? I'm gonna choose Sunary. Sunary. What's wrong? You look so serious. I met Master Rendeo today.
You met Master Rendeo, the craftlord of diamond? I heard that he was on leave.
Oh, was he? So that's why he didn't show up at the opening ceremony.
Yeah, that's what I heard. What was he doing?
He was attacked by soldiers from Dalgaia. But he's very strong, much stronger than I am.
And?
You're trying to say something like, I'm not sure if I can become a craft lord like them, aren't you? Listen, everyone knows that we're unskilled, right? I think there are some special reasons why they want to select a craft lord from us. What do you think?
I've never thought like that. I was always thinking of how I can catch up to them.
Oh, come on, I believe that there are things only young people like us can do, but older people can't. For example, who got the idea to fill the city with flowers? Only a kid could come up with such an idea, right?
She's talking about Razzie.
I think craft lords expect such things from us.
That's pretty good, Sunary. I'd have never come up with an idea like that.
Well, it's just my guess, though. Anyway, I think there is something that only you can do, and other things that others can be trained to do. You can make that the reason why you should become a craft lord.
Okay, thanks, Sunary. Anyway, what is the thing that only you can do?
Huh? That's pretty obvious. I'll become the best swordswoman in the City of Swords. That's all there is to it.
That's great, Sunary.
Big bro!
Razzie, what's the matter?
Big news, big bro! Varel found somebody washed up at the docks.
Meet me there, big bro. I'm going back to help.
See you soon.
Oh, he's gone. Let's get to the port, cutie.
Well, since I obviously spoiled it before, I find it funny that he's still referring to Razzie as a he. Because, well, people may not even remember, and, those of you who did not get spoiled by that episode are going to be spoiled now. Basically, Razzie's a girl. And the funny thing about that is the game, you know, does a very good job keeping you from knowing that unless you spend a whole bunch of time with her. And then eventually, like, I think if you see her so many times, she'll actually reveal it to her. She'll come out dressed as a girl. And yeah, it's cute, I won't lie. But it's only if you, like have been visiting her up to this point that you'll get that, I believe. So yeah, anyway. You know, this is actually a good point to spoil the, like, no, cliffhang. We'll cliffhang on what's at the dock, and instead I will, you know, continue with something else, I guess. Hope you guys enjoyed this game. I hope you were glad to see it back, those of you who were watching it. Those of you who were not, which you guys are watching it anyway, I wish they would give it a chance, don't you guys? Because, I mean, I'm sure there's some people out there who probably have seen it, thought it was cartoonish and stupid, and stopped watching it after the first episode, but those of you who are stuck around to this point, you're probably starting to realize that it's more than that. This game is pretty amazing. I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty amazing. So, yeah. Whatever we do next, look forward to it. Till then, everyone. Bye.